film or video, it's here on 5 in half an hour. First, with very strong language and discussions of a sexual nature from the outset, who'll fall for those feminine wiles this week?
Tonight on The Honey Trap, bare flesh on the beach, feathers in the kitchen, and a real pain in the ass in the bedroom. San Antonio, Ibiza, Europe's busiest party town and home to The Honey Trap, the show that sets out to discover just how far lads will go for a pretty girl. It's 8 p.m. in the center of town. Four boys from rugby are this evening's prey. They've been caught on camera, but will they get caught in the trap? Tash, Angel and Helen are sent in and are immediately noticed by the lads. As they take their seats at the next table, no one wants to miss the view.
Yeah, let's do that. I think that'd be really fun.
In the flash of a thigh, first contact is made.
Why don't we just come over and join you?
And the boys from rugby are hooked, immediately lured into a full sense of security. And what could be better than an invitation to spend the next day up at the girls' villa? After an hour of playing it cool, the lads can finally show their true feelings on the matter. After a night tossing and turning with excitement, the boys are finally reunited with the girls at Honey Trap Villa. If they can't believe their luck, it's because luck had nothing to do with it. What the boys don't know is that the sole mission of their hosts, Tash, Angel, and Helen, is to find out if men will do anything if they're only after one thing. So just who are the girls going to put to the test in tonight's Honey Trap?
You've been saying about my big dick, I've told you about that.
Luke, nicknamed the Sex Bomb.
I'm sure you lot are better than me at playing.
Lee, a counter server in a fried chicken restaurant.
You know we all be tempting our stomach, right?
Aaron has ambitions to be a professional DJ.
You are what you eat and I'm a pussy.
And RD, real name Adam, also fries chicken for a living. For the next 12 hours, every move the boys make will be observed by 20 cameras hidden in the kitchen, lounge, bedrooms, patio, and even bathroom, in addition to the 6 cameras covering the pool. The team behind the scenes can contact the girls through a hidden communication system in the bathroom and through secret calls to their mobile phones. Through a series of honey trap tests, we will observe the behavior of the British lad abroad as he is confronted by his nemesis. The beautiful woman. With the sun overhead, a pool by their side, and a cool drink in hand, the girls make sure the lads are relaxed and ready for the day that lies ahead. The boys think they're onto a winner and seem ready to do just about anything to keep the girls happy.
Oh, fantastic. We've got the right little thing going on here, haven't we?
Honey trap test number one. Lee's boast to his friends is that girls go for his nice ass. But can the models get him to put this prized asset on the line to impress them? Will he allow them to wax his bottom?
He said bring my bottom in and he
yep.
Just stop.
Okay, that is a real wax ass.
It's a bit hairy,
isn't it? Oh, we've got
some
waxing.
Can wax my ass. And if I'm sleeping in your bed.
You can sleep in my bed because I have
a waxing
ass. Angel!
Oh no! That's gonna hurt.
As far as Lee's concerned, he's got naked on a girl's bed, The fact that his mates are there to watch doesn't seem to bother him too much.
No, it's fine.
Just my bum hair, yeah?
Look at that. All over his bum, you do?
No, just on his back.
Angel is going for the full back, crack, and sack wax.
Okay, you ready?
And a new spectator sport is born.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with hairy asses.
Lee's still grinning through the pain, so how will he react when Angel produces an interesting stress-busting toy? It's thorough and it's painful, but is Lee beginning to regret letting his bum do the talking?
Oh my god! No more.
Ow! Is it hurting?
It's like a side table on your arms. No more, please. I want to sit down.
I haven't finished. Who's next for their bum then?
Moments later, RD is targeted. He likes Angel, who, as we know, likes her men hairless. So is he man enough to let her pluck the life out of him?
I like men to be smooth. I know, sweetheart. Is it hurting? Oh, look, it's on the face. Yeah. Right, so you just sprinkle them on. And I'm messing about doing this. They won't grow back as quick either. Cool. There we go.
Thank you.
You're very welcome, darling.
The guys have been plucked, waxed, and buffed to perfection, and now they want to see the results. Luckily, Honeytrap Villa has a good supply of mirrors. Two-way, of course, but they don't know that. So just how vain are British boys? The day just gets better and better when the girls suggest a trip to Kalalonga Beach. Beautiful, unspoilt, isolated. Apart from the Honeytrap cameras capturing every move the lads make. Helen singles Luke out as the next lad to be put to the test. She decides that he will be her little helper of the day. So just how much will Luke do for the very lazy Helen?
Luke, is there any way you can go and find out where my drink is? Can you go and hurry them up?
Are you thirsty?
Yes, well. I'm gagging for it.
Aww.
Well done.
Gagging for
well done, lovely one. Well done.
Woo! Luke hurries off, but there's more to do on his return.
Oh, thank you. Look at that. Oh, my God. How exciting.
Yeah, you feed it to me, then.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, and Luke.
Did anyone bring the factor 30?
No.
Burning up.
Luke. Is there any way you can go and get the thing back?
Just kiss her.
Thank you.
It's all right.
Cool.
You know which one it is, don't you? A little bottle of Nivea. Oh no, I mean there's some cream.
Oh yeah.
With Luke hard at work, the girls suggest the other lads have a dip in the sea. But surely they won't feel the benefit with those hot, stuffy trunks on. Will they go along with the girls' suggestive suggestion?
If you guys go skinny dipping, that's going to be so much fun. You can jump
off. Let's go.
Come on, boys.
I'll go.
Come on, yeah! Come on! Yeah. Come on. Yeah. Come on.
Yeah. Come on.
I don't know.
Boys will be boys. They do indeed go all the way and then take it one step further. With the lads now chilled out, hooked up and stripped bare, it's time to return to Honeytrap Villa. Back by the Honeytrap Villa pool, the girls decide to find out a little more about their exceptionally eager suitors. And what better way to do that than a good old-fashioned game of truth or dare?
How old were you when you first had sex?
I'm going to tell the truth, I think.
Go on, Luke.
No, I'll go around first.
Get it. Lee?
Me? I was 2. No, really. 16.
Luke? 16.
Why don't you just tell the truth?
Yeah, tell the truth, boys.
Yes, lads. Yeah. So what is the truth?
I'm a virgin too.
Yeah.
Really?
So, these lads are virgins. And there's more to come.
How young actually are all you guys? Are you all 18?
Yeah, I'm 17.
Really? Oh, bless you. You don't look that young. You could possibly be older than that.
But guess what I said.
These guys are 17 as well.
Are you?
Oh,
look at
the boy. I'm 18. But yeah, count.
So, our group of 17-year-olds are just the right side of the law. But now Aaron has spilled the beans. Luke's worried the only thing that will get blown today are his chances.
Do they look bothered? They don't look bothered, do they?
They don't bother, do they?
Let's forget the photo, man.
They're not bothered.
It's hard because you wouldn't, yeah, less than 18.
Yeah, it's fine.
Tell the truth.
You're a virgin.
Yes.
Yeah,
but
why
are you
telling
that? They're not
going to
say, "Oh my God, you're a virgin."
Calm down.
So how will the boys prove they're mature enough to take on three sexy older women?
What
have
we got to do now then?
Oh no.
Turn it off again.
Well, of course. They'll drop their pants and take a photo.
Yeah, I've done it.
Next test of maturity. Send two 17-year-olds to the kitchen, and how long before they jump into the inflatable aprons the girls have put there? Not long at all, then.
That was his breast, baby. Look, that was nipple. Yeah, yeah, no, man.
Look through the fridge and see what we call...
Three of the boys are experienced chefs. Well, they work part-time in a fried chicken restaurant, and everyone's feeling a bit peckish. Until, that is, they see what's on the menu.
Oh, nah, someone's bought that chicken. Oh, my God.
It's a whole chicken.
I'm going to get some points for this one. That stick in my trousers on. I don't know what it is. Hold it. Go on, feed it.
Oh, it's nothing plus.
Oh, my God.
It's a full chicken.
The lads' antics haven't impressed the girls. And just what does this sophisticated group of lads do with the dinner ingredients?
It's giving it.
Take a picture,
at this rate, that's the closest our lads are going to get to shagging a bird in Ibiza. Helen's little helper Luke failed to impress on the chicken front, but now's his chance to redeem himself. For his next test, Helen drops her ring down the loo and then colours the water with fizzy drink.
I'll be back in a minute.
Oh, really? I feel awful. I can't get it out. The camera can't flush it. I haven't got anything to get it out with. The thing is, if I flush it, like, no one has to hear. I'm so embarrassed. If I flush it, then it's going to flush it away.
Suspecting that Luke's up to no good with Helen in the loo, Lee sneaks up to investigate, but doesn't quite know how to take what he hears.
Oh, you're so good. Oh, you're so good. Oh, thank you. Can you wash it? Thank you. Can you wash it? Wash your hands. Mm-hmm. Here you go.
Still to come. Trouble downstairs for one lad. And things hot up at the villa.
Do you think she shag him?
If you're looking for a great value for money broadband service, you have to get it from the right place. The place that gives you the benefits of high-speed broadband delivery, as well as exciting movie trailers, extensive sports coverage, and the very latest music videos. So, where's all this included for one monthly fee with one month free?
Go on, where do you think?
Call now for more information on AOL broadband and our free month offer.
I used to be horrified by computers at school. I work in IT communications in the army.
Lawrence!
I hate the name Lawrence. Call me Flo. I provide communications so that the army can do their job. We do use a lot of secret kit. Call 08457 300 treble one.
You already own a piece of communications equipment, use it.
This Valentine's Day, show someone you care with Sainsbury's.
You look beautiful. Come here.
Sometimes the more mascara you apply, the less lashes you seem to have. I was the chief makeup artist on Chicago. Now Max Factor has the answer. More lashes.
A new volumizing formula that sticks to lashes, not to itself, to make you look like you have twice as many lashes.
Twice as seductive.
It looks like you have twice the lashes.
New More Lashes from Max Factor. Now appearing in the major motion picture event, Chicago.
Fragrance from Lynx.
Feel it, you're not helping. I know. Oh, feel it.
Because they get a delicious and different helping every time, cats like Felix find Felix pouches irresistible.
Undercover Brother is Austin Powers meets Shaft.
He had sex with a white girl.
I call it black man's kryptonite.
I see white people.
Undercover Brother.
From tea and coffee. Fill up properly in the morning. Grab a new McDonald's Big Breakfast bun.
Oh, wait. Have dinner with me.
No.
Come on, have dinner with me. I got a nice place. It's down on the beach. View out of every window. Beautiful sunset every night.
No.
Come on, be original.
No.
Back to my place. Hey, I'm a gourmet cook. Come on, let go of the bag. Lady, let go of my bag, will you?
Lethal Weapon 2, Sunday at 9 on 5. Honey Trap Villa, 8 p.m. Our lads, Luke, Lee, Aaron and RD, have spent the day at the villa being entertained by models Tash, Angel and Helen. Girls on a mission to find out what these lads will do if they think they're in on a promise. Earlier today, Lee allowed the girls to wax his behind. Reckoning his arse was a hit with the models, he's now decided to go one step further and put on an impromptu floor show in the bathroom. The only problem is, the girls don't seem to have noticed his star attraction.
Can't see. No, you don't. I've never met. Will you come to do yours as well?
Yeah.
Make up.
Oh, my God. I keep losing weight.
Luckily, someone's having a little more success with the ladies. It seems that Luke might finally be getting somewhere with Helen. What he lacks in technique, he more than makes up for in performance.
It's all right.
It's lovely. Why do you want to stop?
No, that's all right.
You can carry on.
All his mates can do is watch and learn.
Do you mind?
Helen says she wants to carry on in the bedroom. It's the teenage equivalent of winning the lottery. Twice. But before getting down to business, some paperwork. Helen's dodgy poetry is not what Luke had in mind, but if it's a means to an end.
Hi.
makes you very laugh, because I wanted to show you this. Because I think you're really cool, and like people that I kind of get a bit close to, and I haven't known you for long, I show them my book. Is anyone really sad?
So
have you ever written poetry, is that?
Yeah, well, now I'm a dead long.
What was that, Luke?
I was at college, not.
Really?
Yeah,
English. But the thing is, I don't know whether they're any good, because I've never...
Of course, that. Helen does know. She's written the worst verse since Pan Airs, but is Luke too besotted to notice?
Oh,
don't laugh, please.
No.
Why don't you read one out loud?
Helen, hello, hello, hello. Sadness, goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Hello, hello, hello. To happiness, Helen, am I heroine, lovely Helen, Rob. It's pretty good, isn't it?
It's great.
If there's like a bloke, I think it's not on, but it's nice.
Meanwhile, outside, the other lads get straight to the point.
You think she's shagging?
No. I don't
think
she's
really
traditional.
Yeah.
She,
yeah,
you guys obviously...
Luke would
understand.
No, I'm not
going to watch
you.
She's a lot more...
She isn't someone that just sleeps with people.
No,
not really.
She's like a nice
girl. That's Luke's like... What, you know what I mean? She's never the person to sleep with anyone, you know what I mean?
Yeah, she's one of
those. Helen's poetry must be better than she thinks because Luke seems in no hurry to leave. Poor old Luke. Just being close to Helen is proving just a little bit too exciting. Some proper trousers are what's called for. Only trouble is, they're out by the pool along with his envious mates, who are only too happy to congratulate him on rising to the occasion.
Luke, man, that's poking out big time.
He's going to hide it now.
He has a fucking...
Fuck off! Fuck you!
You could have waited till you got inside. He's on his way! Watch out, he might poke you in the face.
Fuck off, Artie.
I get on the front.
Don't be horrible, Artie.
Fuck you.
It must have been at work, right?
And Luke heads back to the villa for a very cold shower. Later that night, Angel receives some bad news. Her mother and father have just arrived from Britain, expecting to meet Angel's new fiancé. In a BAFTA-winning performance, Angel explains that the engagement is off, but she hasn't yet broken the news to Mum and Dad.
I haven't told Mum yet about me. It's all right. It's all right.
Angel directs her tearful plea at Lee. Can she persuade the self-confessed Romeo from Rugby to take the place of her fiancé?
Would you do it?
If you want me to, yeah.
There's just one thing Angel forgot to mention.
He's German. Can you speak with a German accent?
Oh, God.
No, it's really easy. I swear to God, Peter spoke really... And he's
going to have to do this
Angel,
quite seriously, though.
Angel, it's such a wonderful...
Can you do it? That's so good. That's brilliant.
Say again.
Really.
I will have you, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Lee, do it again. Say
it. I love you. Oh, my God, this is...
Hello,
oh,
yeah. Lovely.
Oh, the journey
hello.
We've had.
Hi. Hi.
My God.
Yeah, not bad at all. Not bad at all. Yeah.
Wonderful.
Hi, I'm Chris.
Hi.
This is Peter. Hello, Peter. Hi. I'm
hello, Peter.
Hi.
Oh, this is so nice.
You like it?
This is your friend's villa.
Yes, it's very
nice. Oh, this is fabulous.
It's very nice.
Oh, absolutely shattered.
Oh,
I can't believe it.
He's mastered the accent, but there's one other thing about her fiance that Angel didn't tell him.
And you're
very nice to meet you, Bob.
And you're a model.
I know. Yeah.
What sort of modelling do you do?
Oh, body parts, but no.
Body parts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I see what you do for your face.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Oh. Why is my bum? It's like. Ooh.
I've been dying to meet you.
Do you want a drink?
You know, well, I'd really love a drink. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because
oh,
we
have a drink.
Yeah, yeah.
Have a beer?
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm beer. I'm
a
beer.
A good German handshake.
That's
this is yeah.
Very good English.
And the father has another surprise up his sleeve for poor Lee.
I know a few words of German. Yeah.
You liar, you've been practising on the plane.
Ich spreche ein bisschen Deutsch. Is that good?
Is
yeah?
Good?
Very good, very good.
Oh, good.
Good.
Oh, good, yeah.
He'll bore you to death.
That's okay.
My little angel.
I'll take him to the kitchen. We get a beer.
Lee's coping well so far, but can he keep up the act when he's left in the kitchen with his future parents-in-law?
Okay.
I think I would like a beer, please.
Yes.
Okey-doke.
Well, somebody's going to get me a drink.
Oh, yes, of course.
Neighbor?
And one for Mummy. Where did you come from, Peter?
Berlin.
Oh, Berlin.
Yeah. It's a nice city.
Yeah.
But London is so busy. And
is that like where your family live? Your mother
yes,
and father
Berlin,
live
yes.
in Berlin?
Yes.
Yeah.
But I go to London for work.
Yeah.
But it's very nice. And I meet your daughter. She's a wonderful girl.
And your parents, will they come to Ibiza for the wedding?
Yes, yes, sure. Yeah.
Well,
I'll get them, yeah.
To
obviously, to meet you too, yeah.
Yeah. Top marks to young Lee. He's a cunning linguist, after all. With midnight approaching, the lads must feel they've earned their place at the model's side. After all they've done for them.
Oh. Oh. I like making smooth. I know.
Luke, is there any way you can go and find out where my drink is? I'm gagging for it.
Oh.
Come on, boys.
Okay.
I
flush it and it's going to flush it away. Oh, why don't you read one?
Hello.
Can you speak with German accent?
Ich spreche ein bisschen Deutsch.
They were expecting a night to remember, and that's exactly what they're going to get. It's time to come clean.
You've been caught. In the honey trap.
Come on. Wicked. Brilliant, isn't it?
Hello. Girls have been wonderful, when I'm all thinking, yeah, we're going to get in there tonight, staying over. And then the camera pops out and I'm thinking, no.
Come on, darling.
Put that down.
Yeah, lads will go to any length to try and get the kill they can.
Yeah.
Through this day, I thought that girls are much more cunning than I thought.
Oh, you were absolutely amazing.
In the future, if I do meet any beautiful ladies like that, I'll be careful, because I know they're after someone.
No boys were harmed in the course of making this programme. However, they were sent on a long, peaceful trip, courtesy of Open Holidays, to recover from the whole experience.
Next tonight, mistress of movie erotica Eden is your late-night hostess for all that's outrageous on film and video, out there.